Guys, so I know I've been a little MIA, but as y'all can tell on my voice, I am sick. I've been sick, and I don't know if y'all saw Brandon's post, but Brandon did test positive for COVID a couple of days ago, and that prevented him from being able to train properly, go to the gym, spar, and all of that good stuff. I know he's been getting a lot of negative comments. People saying that it's BS, people saying that it's staged, that he's backing out, people even getting mad, like, why wasn't he more careful? Why was he surrounding himself with his family? And I will explain that right now because I feel like Brandon tried to explain himself, but I feel like I can explain myself better. Okay, so for those of you guys that don't know, Brandon doesn't train here at home. We leave for training camp. This time we left to California for two. We had already been over there for about 2 months, 2.5 months, training. And Brandon's team is his family. So it's me, my mom, my younger brother, and Brandon. We're all living in the same house. My dad was staying somewhere separate. But I don't know, my parents are divorced. So, just to make things less complicated, my dad stays somewhere else. And then we would go obviously train at the gym together. My dad would meet us up there, go home, go back to the gym, go home, go back to the gym. Literally, the guys, that's all that we do. Like, it's so rare if we go anywhere. One, we don't have the time for it. Two, sometimes Brandon, he's just so focused. Like, we don't, I think the only thing that we did do was like escape rooms where we reserve a room. And it, so anyways, so everything had been great. Brandon had been doing so good. His weight was on point, his training on point. Like, it was just going super, super good. And I believe this was 2 or 3 weeks before his fight day. He started getting like symptoms. He started getting sick. He woke up with puffy eyes, red. And I even told him, like, Brandon, it looks like you've been crying all night. Like, what's wrong with your eyes? He's like, I don't know. It's weird. And then my mom started getting sick. Him and my mom started getting sick first. My mom, it hit her pretty bad. Honestly, it was just so hard. She's fine. She's fine now. But my mom, I don't know. It was just hard, guys. So that's why it gets me mad when people start talking like smack or saying negative things. Because it's like, this is his family. Like, this is my family. Like, Brandon's team is his family. Obviously, it's gonna stress him out. It's gonna hurt him. So they started getting sick. I was perfectly fine. My younger brother was perfectly fine. We're carrying the team on our backs, doing the best that we could for my mom and for Brandon. And it wasn't until maybe the third day that I told Brandon, like, you know what? Like, you need to go get tested. Like, this is already too much. My mom was getting worse and worse. My mom would not leave the house. She was asleep like 20 hours out of the day. I would go out and get medicine for everybody, like, take care of them the best I could. And sure enough, when Brandon got tested, he tested positive. So we quarantined, we waited. And honestly, guys, it sucks because think about it. Like, why would this be something that we would want to happen? All of us had been over there for 2 months. I left my business, I left my husband, I left Brandon, left everybody back home. We all did. We all sacrificed so much, and we were so close to the finish. Once we found out Brandon was positive, obviously we all talked about it. Brandon literally looked at me and he's like, what should I do? He was so, like, you could tell he was so disappointed and at the same time so worried because my mom was super sick. I didn't start getting sick until maybe like 5 days after that, but he really, really wanted it. He's like, you know what? I'm gonna keep training. He kept doing his diet. We couldn't go to the gym anymore. He couldn't spar anymore. But he would go run outside every day. I think one time he even did like 6 miles, and then I would try my best to give him a little like strength and conditioning workout outside. We literally tried our best. But even if Brandon would have came out negative like a week before the fight, that would have been such a disadvantage. And COVID does have like its effects after, even if, like, let's say you're over and done with it, like, it does have its effects after. So as a team, I feel like we made the right decision to just postpone the fight. Let Brandon recover, like, really get over this whole COVID thing, and then go back, train again, and ni modo. Like, it's not something that was planned, obviously, not something that we would have wanted, but the good thing is that his fight is just postponed, it's not canceled. It's still gonna happen. I know a lot of you guys were so disappointed because y'all really wanted to watch this fight. Trust me, guys,
No one is going to be more disappointed than freaking Brandon. I saw it myself. I could tell he felt so bad because all of us had been working so hard. And I told him, you know what, Brandon? Like, we're not your employees. We're your family. Like, we're here for you. Like, you fall, we all fall. Obviously, he got sick. We all got sick. What were we gonna do? Kick out my mom, the one that was worse? Like, no, we were all living together. So, and we're family, guys. We care about each other. We're not just gonna do each other like that, you know? So yeah, moral of the story is we're all okay. My mom is fine. I'm fine. Brandon is fine as well. We're all okay. Thank you guys for those of y'all that really care about Team Figueroa and that we're concerned. And for the rest of you guys that are saying like it's BS or Brandon's backing out, like honestly, at this point, guys, family comes first and our health comes first and Brandon's health comes first. Like, I would have not wanted him to go to the fight with that disadvantage of him not being 100% healthy. Like, y'all need to think about that too. Like, I know you guys want to see a fight, but it's like Brandon has family. Like, he has people that care about him. Like, we're not gonna want him to just go and fight like that. And I'm so glad that Al Heyman was so understanding of this and he cares about Brandon and about all of us, and he was willing to postpone it. And it's not gonna be postponed till next year. It is gonna be sooner than y'all think. So, yes. So yeah, guys, look at this little hair. I just what was I gonna say? I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. I'm just talking too much. But anyways, I'm sorry for making that so long. I just needed to get everything out there. I don't like when people talk shit about my brothers or my whole family, period. I will always stand up for them. So especially because I was there, I saw like this is not anything that was freaking intentional, you know? That's dumb. It's not that we wanted to happen. Like, I didn't want my mom to freaking get sick and Brandon to get sick or myself to get sick, you know? Like, who would want that? But shit happens. That's life, as funny as it may seem. That's one of my favorite songs from Frank Sinatra. If y'all don't know, now you know. I think right now I'm just talking way too much. So I'm gonna get this homework going, and yeah, I don't know what else to say. Thank you guys, love you guys.